Earlier today, a new volcanic eruption began in Iceland, and early indications suggest that it may be one of the largest recent eruptions on the peninsula so far. What you are looking at is the scene filmed today at a paved road just north of Iceland's town of Grindavik being covered by a fresh lava flow. However, despite the proximity and speed of this more than 1,000 degrees Celsius lava to the town of Grindavik, its structures are for now safe, as the lava barriers are so far doing their job quite well, redirecting lava away from or around the town. Here is where I have geolocated the new lava flows to so far, indicating that molten rock has rapidly covered an area of 2.23 square kilometers. This eruption began at 12:46 p.m. local time in Iceland on May 29th of 2024 when a fissure unzipped about 3,400 meters east of the Blue Lagoon. Within 10 minutes, this fissure had expanded to a kilometer in length, expanding both towards the northeast and the southwest. Soon, the fissure cut right through the main spatter cone which had formed during the most recent prior eruption, which lasted for 54 days between March 16th and May 9th of 2024. This provided spectacular scenes such as this, with lava fountains shooting up to a height of 113 meters or 371 feet. As this fissure further expanded, it eventually reached a length of 3.4 kilometers or 2.11 miles, rapidly sending lava flows towards the south since this represented a downslope region. I estimate that lava effusion peaked at a rate of around 1,100 cubic meters per second, with the current eruptive rate already decreasing. This is not all that unexpected, considering that each one of the prior seven Reykjanes Peninsula eruptions since 2021 started with their strongest lava effusion, which then slowly but surely decreased over time until the eruption ended. While a plume of gases is rising several kilometers into the atmosphere, I would not call the Reykjanes Volcano's current eruption as primarily explosive. Part of the reason we are seeing dark gray plumes that might be incorrectly interpreted as ash, as this represents oil products which paved roads are comprised of melting and then boiling as lava passes over them. However, the southernmost part of the fissure has actually produced intermittent weak ash plumes, likely due to the interaction of magma with groundwater in that sector. Part of the reason the current lava flow seems to have such a high speed when compared to prior recent eruptions is that a section of fissure ran through the edge of the Hagafell Hill, causing lava once erupted to be accelerated by the force of gravity. This lava flow is likely to continue further along towards the southwest, but whether or not it will reach the ocean in that sector is still an open question. If lava does, however, reach the ocean, then production of hydrochloric acid and explosive reactions with the seawater will occur, meaning, in my opinion, that at least a 3-kilometer exclusion zone would be needed around any point where this is occurring. Lava could also eventually divert towards the southeast as during the last eruption, while the northernmost section of erupting fissure could feed a lava flow north of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant. Thankfully, no one other than the construction workers and engineers stabilizing and expanding the dirt lava barriers are still in Grindavik, as the town was evacuated a full 106 minutes before the eruption commenced. A strong earthquake swarm indicating the movement of magma had begun at 10:24 a.m., thus causing Grindavik to be evacuated around 11 a.m. It thus took only 2 hours and 22 minutes from the onset of activity for an eruption to commence. It is unclear how long the current eruption will last, but you should expect to see eruptive activity drop by at least 75% in the next 24 hours. However, at least 20 million cubic meters of magma is available, meaning that at least around this total should end up erupting. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, James Madison Beavis, for supporting this YouTube channel.